So today we are going to solve the class 4 IMO paper, which is of level 2 type, and we are looking at set 4, and this is a 2019 paper. The first section is the mathematics section here. In the last video, we solved the first 10 questions of this paper, and now we'll take it on from the 11th question. The difference between 21 hundredths, 5 tens, 8 ones, and the sum of 980 and 1405 is dash. I have underlined the numbers for your ease. Try to solve and choose the right answer. So we need to find difference between two numbers, and for the first one it is 21 hundredths, that is 21 times 100, which is equal to 2100. 5 tens, that is 5 times 10, which is equal to 50. 8 ones, that is 8 times 1, which is equal to 8. So the number is 2158. This is our number 1. Our number 2 is sum of 980 and 1405. So let's do that. 980 plus 1405. Well, this is equal to 0 plus 5 is 5. 8 plus 0 is 8. 9 plus 4 is 13. 3 carry 1 and 1 plus 1 is 2. So this is our second number. Now we need to find the difference between the two. So we will subtract the bigger number 2385 from the smaller number 2158. What would this be? Well, 5 will borrow 1 from 8, making it 15. 15 minus 8 is 7. 7 minus 5 is 2. 3 minus 1 is 2. And 2 minus 2 is 0. So 227 is the answer, which is 2 hundredths and 2 tens and 7 ones. That is your option C. So that's your right answer. Next question. A typist can type 90 words in 180 seconds. Find the number of words she can type in 300 seconds if she maintains a constant speed. Try to solve this. Your options are given below. So the typist in 180 seconds, she types 90 words. So how much does she type in 1 second? Well, in 1 second, she'll type 90 words divided by 180. Now what we need to find is how much she will type in 300 seconds. So in 300 seconds, she'll type 90 by 180 words times 300, because she types this in 1 second. So in 300, she'll type this 300 times. Now let's try to do this. 0 and 0 go here. 9 times 1 is 9. 9 times 2 is 18. And 300 divided by 2, well, that is equal to 150. So the typist types 150 words in 300 seconds. That is our option A. Next question. A shopping mall closes at 10:30 p.m. Its operating hours is 10 hours and 45 minutes. What time does the shopping mall open? Try to work this out and choose from the answers below. Then we'll solve it together and match our answer. So now, the shopping mall closes at 10:30 p.m. and the operating hours are 10 hours 45 minutes. So let's also convert this into hours. So 10:30 p.m. is after 12 hours, we add 10 more hours and 30 minutes. So which is equal to, so after 12, okay, so I'll write 12.00. So this is equal to 12 plus 10, that is 22 hours and 30 minutes. Now this is the ending time. Now from 22 hours and 30 minutes, we subtract 10 hours and 45 minutes. Now that is equal to how much? Well, 30 is less than 45, right? Now when we solve this, 30 minus 45, well, the number that is subtracted is greater than 30 minutes. So 30 minus 45 is minus 15 minutes. Now let's subtract this 22 hours minus 10 hours, well, that is 12 hours. So from 12 hours, we should subtract 15 minutes. Well, if you have your clock and it's 12, to subtract 15 minutes, that means your minute hand goes 15 minutes back. So your hour hand will be here. So the time would be 11:45. So 12 hours minus 15 minutes is 11:45 a.m. because 11 is less than 12. So it is in the morning time. Hence our right answer is option B, 11:45 a.m. Next question. Q is the smallest whole number which is greater than 99. Find the greatest possible whole number which is less than Q times Q. And your options are given below. Think and try to get the right answer. I'll give you some time. Okay, let's solve this together. Now, Q is the smallest whole number which is greater than 99. So, the number that is greater than 99 is 100, and this is the whole number. It is not 99.1 because that would not be whole number. So 100 will be Q. Now find the greatest possible whole number which is less than Q times Q. So Q times Q would be 100 times 100. So there are 4 zeros. So your answer will be 4 zeros preceded by 1. So this is 10,000. Now which number is less than 10,000? Now to find the greatest possible whole number which is less than 10,000, we just need to subtract it by 1, which will be equal to 9,999. So your answer is option D. Next question. 159 students went to the zoo. 84 of them were boys and rest were girls. If the girls were grouped into groups of 5, then how many groups of girls were there? Alright, so this needs to be solved step by step. Now the total number of students who went to the zoo is equal to 159. And 84 of them were boys, so the number of boys is 84. So how many would be number of girls? Well, the number of girls would be the total number of kids in the zoo minus the number of boys. So this is equal to 9 minus 4 is 5. 5 will get a borrow from 1. So 15 minus 8 is 7. So 75 were girls, because here they say rest were girls. Now these 75 girls were made up into groups of 5. So how many groups would that be? Well, that will be 75 divided by 5. So 5 times 1 is 5, leaving us with 2, and then 5 comes down. 5 times 5 is 25, which is having a remainder of 0. So 75 divided into groups of 5 would give us 15 groups in all. So how many groups of girls were there? It is option A, 15 groups. Next question. Find the value of P minus Q plus R times S. And here we have a multiplication from where we need to find the numbers. Pause the video if you need more time. Okay, let's try to solve this together. Now, when you have this number, start from the lowest answer and then go up to find the others. Now, in the lowest, we see that 6 plus 0 is 6, 6 plus 1 is 7. There is no carry forward. So, we have R plus 8 is S, and then 3, but the answer is 4. So definitely there would be a carry forward here, and 1 plus 0 is 1. So what we get is R plus 8 is equal to a 2-digit number, which is 10 plus S, because the 1's place is what is written in the answer here in S. Now R plus 8 is equal to, so we need to subtract 8 from both sides, so we get R is equal to S plus 2, because 10 minus 8 is 2. Let's keep this aside. Now let's go up. Now let's go to the multiplication. Now 4 times P is 6 raised to something, because no multiple of 4 is only 6. So here we have P times 4 is equal to a multiple which would be ending in 6. So there would be some number here. Now the multiple of 4 which ends in 6 can either be 9. So P can either be 9, because 9 times 4 is 36. Or P can be equal to 4, because 4 times 4 is also number ending in 6, that is 16. So let's try to replace both of them. Let's say this is 9. So 9 times 4 is 36, 6 carry 3. 4 times 5 is 20 plus 3. This should have been 3, but that is not the case. So P is not 9. Let's see if it is 4. Now let's do 4 here. 4 times 4 is 16, 6 carry 1. 4 times 5 is 20 plus 1. So it is rightly put 1 here, and it will carry 2. And 4 times 1 is 4 plus 2 would be 6. So we get R to be equal to 6. And if 6 is S plus 2, that means S is equal to 4. So we get R and S and P also. So we deduce that P is equal to 4. So we have P, R and S. Now all we need to find is Q. Now let's multiply Q to 154. So I'll put 0 in the first place and then let me start. So Q times 4 is something that is ending in 6. So again we are with the same situation, that Q times 4 is equal to a number ending in 6. Either it can be 9 or 4. Let's try 9. So if this is 9, 9 times 4 is 36, 6 carry 3. 9 times 5 is 45 plus 3, 48. Good so far, and carry 4. 9 times 1 is 9 plus 4 is 13. So 9 fits correctly. So Q would be equal to 9. Now that we have found all of this, let's replace it in the equation. So P is 4. Minus Q is 9 plus R is 6 times S is 4. Now in this equation, we remember the Bodmer's rule. So first is multiplication, then is addition, then is subtraction. So first we'll do this. 6 times 4 is 24. So we have 24 minus 9 plus 4. So 24 plus 4 is 28. Minus 9, which is equal to 19. So your answer is option D, 19. Let's go to our next question. Shubhra bought 12 meter of cloth to make 3 pairs of pants and 2 shirts. If she used 2.7 meters of cloth to make each pair of pants and 1.9 meter to make each shirt, then how much cloth was left? Okay, let's solve this together. So Shubhra had 12 meters of cloth in all, and out of this she makes 3 pairs of pants. And how much we see that she has used 2.7 meters of cloth to make each pair of pant. So that means she uses 2.7 meters times 3 to make pants. So this is the amount of cloth used for pants. Let me write this here. Well, how much is this? 3 times 7 is 21, 1 carry 2, 3 times 2 is 6, plus 2 is 8, and there is a point after one number, so it is 8.1 meter. Now what else has she made? So she has made shirts. And how many shirts are there? Well, there are two shirts. So two shirts is equal to how much cloth? Well, one shirt is 1.9 meter. So it is 1.9 times 2, which is equal to 2 times 9 is 18. 8 carry 1, 2 times 1 is 2 plus 1, 3. So, and decimal is before one number, so 3.8 meters. So how much cloth has she used up? So let's add them two together. 1 plus 8 is 9. There's my decimal, and 8 plus 3 is 11. So 11.9 meters cloth is used. What we need to find is how much cloth was left. Now out of 12 meters, that is 12 meters here, I subtract 11.9. So the way to write it is 12.0 minus 11.9. Let's do this. 0 is less than 9, so it will borrow here. 10 minus 9 is 1. 1 minus 1 is 0, and 1 minus 1 is 0. So 0.1 meter cloth was left. But if you look at the answers, only there is one option of meters, which is 11 meters. That is not the right answer. Rest are in centimeters. Now remember the conversion, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So we'll multiply this by 100.
So 100 times 1 is 100, and in point 1 there is a single number after the decimal point. So in our answer also we'll put a decimal point just before the last zero. So our answer is
10 centimeters, which is option B. Heading to the 18th question, which says, find the perimeter of the figure not drawn to scale given below. Here are the measurements given. Find the perimeter and choose the right answer. I'll hold on for a while. Well, here we just need to add the sum of the boundaries together to get the perimeter. So let's do this. 6 plus 4 is 10. 10 plus 4 is 14. So these three make it 14. Let's simplify here. 5 and 5 is 10. 8 and 2 is 10. And 12 and 3 is 15. So 10 plus 10 is 20. And 15 plus 14 is 29. So when we add this, it is 49 centimeter, which is your option C. Easy one. Next question. Winner gained 2 kgs 775 grams. What was his weight earlier if he weighs 58 kg 215 grams now? The answer is hidden in one of the options below. Solve this and get your answer. So let's write, what does Vinay weigh now? So Vinay weighs now, so the weight that Vinay is now is 58 kgs and 215 grams. Now 1 kg is equal to 1000 grams. So 58 kg is 58,000 grams plus 215 grams. So this is equal to 58,215 grams in all. And Vinay had gained 2 kg 75 grams. So what he gained? Well, he gained 2 kgs and 775 grams. Now 2 kg is 2,000 grams. And to that we add 775 grams. So Vinay has gained 2775 grams. So what was his weight earlier? So his weight earlier was 58,215 grams minus what he gained, that is 2775 grams. Let's subtract this. 5 minus 5, 0.
1 will borrow 1 from 2, so 11 minus 7 is 4. 7 minus, again 1 will borrow from 8, so 11 minus 7 is 4 again. 7 minus 2 is 5, and this 5 comes down. So 55,000, we can write this as 55,000 plus 440 grams. Now why we split it in thousands and hundreds? Well, 55,000 is nothing but 55 kilograms and 440 grams. This is his weight, which matches our option A in the answer. Next question. There were 1800 girls and 960 boys in a hall. An hour later, 7/10 of the girls left the hall. How many children were in hall after an hour? Think and solve this answer. Choose the answer from the given options. Time starts now. Okay, so let's write the number of girls and boys in the hall. Now the number of girls were 1800 and the number of boys were 960. Now 7/10 of the girls left. So let me draw a block containing of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. 10 equal parts. Now out of this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 girls left. So how many were remaining? Well, 1, 2 and 3. So 3 out of the 10 girls were remaining in the hall after 1 hour. That means after 1 hour, we have 3/10 of the girls remaining. So 3/10 times 1800. Now let's divide the 1800 by 10. 0 and 0 cancels. Now let's multiply 3 by 180, which is equal to 3 times 0 is 0, 3 times 8 is 24, 4 carry 2, 3 times 1 is 3, plus 2, 5. So 540 girls are in the hall after 1 hour. And how many boys? Well, the same number of boys because nobody left. So after 1 hour, the total number of students, so we add 540 and 960. Let's do that. 0 plus 0 in 1's place is 0. 6 plus 4 in 10's place is 10, carry 1. 9 plus 1 is 10, plus 5 is 15. So there are 1500 students that are left after 1 hour, which is option B. So after this, let's take a short break and let's continue with the rest of our paper in our next video.